I made us lose $15,000. There's a reason why we don't own a house yet. Welcome back, guys, to another video. Happy Thursday. Today is a video about growth, and we thought that instead of doing a video about our YouTube growth, we would do a video about personal growth and how we motivate each other and ourselves, and just in general, everything that has to do with being an entrepreneur and your mental health and all of that. So if you are an entrepreneur, an aspiring entrepreneur, if you have troubles getting motivated or having the D word, which we're going to tell you in a couple seconds, this is the video for you.
For you. Yeah. So small little disclaimer. If she's having a little lisp while talking, she literally just got operated in her mouth 2 days ago. She's super swollen. She had 3 teeth removed because of an infection. And if you're looking at my face and I'm super red, I'm just letting you guys know that, yes, we do own a roofing company. Yes, I do spend a lot of time on a roof. And yes, my face gets toasted. So just so you guys know, like, that we don't look too weird. We're real working life people. And we do have our little set goals that we're bringing to you guys, and this is what this video is all about, so take it over. All
right, so the word that changed our life, or is the word that could change your life, could change anybody's life.
Will change your life.
Will change your life. Did change our life is...
Discipline.
Discipline. It seems so simple.
But yet, very complicated.
So complicated. Discipline is something that I have lacked since I am very young. It's something I work with constantly. I work on this literally to this day. Every day I work on my discipline.
It's a battle.
It is a battle. I have people in my life that have truly shaped my discipline and have made me better. But it is a constant battle to be disciplined. And as entrepreneurs, there are no people telling you what to do. There are no people telling you, giving you incentives and being like, you need to sell this much to get a raise. Or there's nobody patting you on the back, except for when you have an amazing partner. But
it's rare.
Yeah, it's very rare that you have somebody there
telling
to just
you.
to tell you, like, good job, or you need to do this, or you need to, like, you're your own boss. But what if you're a crappy boss? Like, what if you're a cool boss and you have no rules? I used to think that having a schedule or having somebody tell me what to do or even just like being super, super disciplined meant that you weren't free. But the truth is, having a schedule, having a system is really what makes you free. You need to be organized. And that goes for whether you are a stay-at-home mom and your house is a mess. It goes if you are an entrepreneur, if you are a student, anything.
It goes for anything.
It goes for literally, literally anything. It could be simple things like making your bed in the morning. There is a reason why in the army they tell them to make their beds in the morning. You can watch so many videos or people that have been in the army and they're like, when you wake up early. That's something I'm also working on. I can't do yet. But the first thing you do when you wake up is make your bed. And they say, why? That's so insignificant. But it just means that if you can complete that one thing that you have on your list every morning, you are accountable. And I find accountability is something that people are really missing these days.
Very important.
You know, you do anything and it's just so easy to blame other people for everything that happens around you. And it's so easy to blame laws and blame this, that accountability is just something that's really important. Yeah. What do you think?
What I think about discipline is, one, it's very important. I came from a place where there was discipline, but it just wasn't enforced in the right way. So I was forced to self-teach myself what discipline was all about. And that was through making a lot of mistakes. The number one thing that I decided to do was making little daily, weekly, monthly challenges with myself. So this means going to battle with your mindset. And the only way that you will be able to achieve success is by choosing small little goals. So for example, one thing that I ended up doing was helping Samantha after her birth, you know, going through all the emotions and all the hormone changes and
postpartum, like, depression.
Postpartum depression. There was a lot of days that she was feeling, you know, not too sure about herself, not too like comfortable, not too great. So I ended up just telling her, choose a little, one little thing that you could do in one day that you know you'll be able to achieve. And then once you succeed at achieving that, then add another thing to your list.
It helped me tremendously. I felt like a big, I've spoken about this before, I felt like a big zero after I gave birth. Because I had a C-section and I was unable to do anything except for just walk. And it was really hard. I felt unaccomplished. And it was, I just, some mornings I didn't want to get out of bed. And thank goodness I have Evan, my partner in business, in life, in my baby daddy, my everything. because I don't know what I would have done. Like, I know how hard it is. And postpartum depression is real.
So this example not only, you know, focuses on, you know, pregnancy or whatever, whatever stage of your life you're in, like, it literally touches everything that you do in your life, because you have to be able to challenge yourself in everything you do, because your mind is the control of your greatness. If you cannot control your mind to think great about yourself, you will never achieve greatness. And again, disclaimer, we are not professionals in this. We are not even at the level that we think that we should be at. But we're just giving you guys little examples that we've done that have helped us achieve, you know, the beginning stages of what we're trying to create for ourselves and for our life. So for example, on my end, so like, let's talk about a man trying to like program his brain or his mindset to be able to achieve certain things. So what I've tried doing is creating little challenges of, for example, being able to do 100 push-ups a day for 100 days.
And okay? you're so thorough with that since before we went on vacation.
Yeah, so I've been wanting to like push myself to be able to do that, not of the physical aspect of it, not for like the body change, not to impress my fiance, not to impress people around me, but it's more for myself. It's more for myself to be able to tell myself that, hey, I've worked a 9-hour day or a 10-hour day. I came home. I'm tired. I'm taking care of the kids. I have to be up at 5:30 in the morning, redo the same thing again. But it's all about telling myself, hey, you're feeling tired. You're not able to do it. Maybe you don't have the energy, but push yourself.
And do it.
Do it. Even if your mind doesn't feel like it, and even if your body's telling you no, you have to push yourself. And by being able to trick your brain to being able to like give yourself that extra boost to be able to conquer that, that's the beginning stages of being able to conquer other tasks in your life.
Yeah.
For example, another example, and I don't want to ramble on too long, but it's happened to me so many times where I'm on a job, I've worked a 12-hour day, a client needs to see me and says, hey, can you come see me, please? I need to see a color of like
a shingle
or whatever. And I'm just beat. I'm just overall tired. I just have no more energy. And I tell myself, hey, you know what? Go see that client you know, that could be an extra job. That could be like money and food on the table for your family. Mm-hmm. That could be that extra birthday gift, Christmas gift, vacation for the family. And let me tell you, every time I've pushed myself to be able to like just go that extra little step to be able to go see a client and explain to them what they need and what they want, let me tell you, I've sold every single job that I've actually pushed myself to go see these clients. So my whole point is to just be able to give yourself that energy, that mental state of mind, to be able to push yourself out of your comfort zone to achieve what you want to get to in the long run.
Yeah. I think there's really a stigma around mental illness. And again, disclaimer, we are not doctors or psychologists.
Nor professionals.
Nor professionals. But this is really how we go about our life, and we have dealt with certain mental illnesses, you could say. I think the stigma around that is like there's something wrong with you, there's something wrong with being depressed, and it's kind of like people put a label on it and they're like, oh, you're depressive, and then that's it, you're depressive, you're stuck with it. But if you're driving a car, one day it could be fine and the next day your car can be broken. And then you fix it and your car is fine. And I think that is just how our minds are. You have a cold. You have a cold. Your body feels like shit, right? Excuse my language. You sleep it off. You take a couple vitamins. You feel better. You have an infection. You take medication, whatever it is. Then you go about your life. I think mental health is the same way. You can wake up one morning and feel totally depressed. And that's okay. And you have to combat that in your mind. And whether you have a good support system around you or whether you have built your own building blocks of your mental health, that is what's going to pull you out of it. And it is so true. You are not, you can't look at other people and be like, oh, they have a perfect life. They never wake up depressed. That's not true. On social media, we can have really nice pictures that we're smiling, but I could tell you there's some mornings I didn't want to get out of bed. Mm-hmm. And that's super normal. It doesn't make you a depressive person or like this problematic person that needs fixing. You need to just, you just need to look at yourself in the mirror, find the problem. Is it because you have no confidence? Perfect. Find out why you have no confidence. Find out what you like about yourself. Find out what you don't like about yourself. You don't need to like everything about yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You need to figure out why you don't like that. You're impatient. You do these things that you don't like. You argue too much, like me.
Mm-hmm.
That I don't like about myself. It's okay. You know what? Change it. You don't like the way you're eating? Change that. Work on it. It's by doing those things and being real with yourself and being accountable that you are going to grow. And unless you look at yourself in the mirror and you tell yourself bluntly, like you have a problem, you will never fix yourself, no matter what pills you take, no matter what psychologist you go see. You can go see anybody. But at the end of the day, if the problem is you, you're the one who needs fixing. And if you're going to go see somebody to try to help you, but when you get home, you're just going to tell yourself that you suck and that you have, you know, nothing's going right and that life sucks, you can go see anybody, but your life is not going to get better.
To put my little touch on this, and again, another disclaimer, because this could be very touchy for, you know, viewers. We don't know who's going to be watching this, but, you know, there are people out there with, you know, severe, serious, like, issues, right? Mental issues.
Exactly.
That, like, cannot be controlled. And we're not touching on that aspect because, again, like Samantha said, we're not doctors. We're not here to, like, pinpoint on every situation. But we're here to talk about, like, everyday little tasks and goals. We're talking about, like, you know, mental laziness. We're talking about somebody that just doesn't have the inspiration to be able to, like, make that extra step to be a better person, to be greater, to be better at what you're doing.
And at their full potential.
Exactly. You know, so, like, that's what we're touching on mostly. So we just wanted to let you guys know that we're not...
Yeah, because we don't run at our full potential. Like, nobody truly runs at their full
potential.
There's
not one person that's running at their full potential, and I'll tell you why. Every day that goes by, you can grow as a person and you can better yourself every single day, no matter how old you are.
Exactly. No wonder,
if you're 10 years old, 8 years old, 2 years old, 90 years old, 100 years old, it doesn't matter.
Like, you're never the best.
You're never the best.
And that's okay.
And we teach that to our children
every
day. You're never going to be the top dog of this world because there's always going to be somebody that's better than you, somebody that's outdoing you, and that's okay.
Exactly.
That's number one thing that you have to be acceptant about yourself. You got to accept that there's always going to be somebody else out there that's doing something a little bit better than you.
Somebody
you got to be
with
able
more
to,
followers,
exactly,
a bigger YouTube channel.
You got to be able to move on and concentrate on yourself. Again, not to ramble too much, but a little example from my part. So I look at your mental health as almost like building something from scratch. So if you're building something materialistic, for example, I'm gonna take my story because I can't really like give
you
a story
relate
that
everything to cars.
Yeah. Well, at least for myself.
Yeah.
So I decided last year to build a motorcycle from scratch. I never built a motorcycle from scratch. I've changed little parts here and there on it, but I decided to literally take this motorcycle apart down to the bare bones.
I'm gonna put a picture of it. Right here. Actually, you are. Right here. Okay, go.
And rebuild it. So,
because it was fantastic.
I made a lot of mistakes building this bike. I learned a lot of things building this bike.
A lot of swear words.
Went through a lot of like hours and time, and I would work during the day and come home at night and work on it and work on the weekends and took a lot of time off the family to be able to build that.
Breaking clutch line.
But one thing it taught me is that no matter what happened to that bike, I was able to fix. Because I took apart the whole bike, I was literally, in my mind, no matter what happened to this, I knew exactly where to pinpoint where the problem was and to be able to rectify it and fix it right on the spot.
And you did.
And I did. I really think that that is the same way you should control your mind. That if you're mentally feeling, you know, challenged about something or like, hey, you know what, like, I don't think I could be able to, like, take that on, or I don't know if I could, like, you know, go to this new job because, you know, I'm not maybe qualified as well as, like, the other workers, or maybe, you know, I'm an entrepreneur and, like, I'm willing to invest, like, this new $100,000 or $150,000 in this new truck or new building or new spot or advertising to be able to, like, grow my business, and you're, like, second-guessing yourself, you have to be able to recognize, you know, what you're doing and how to dissect a situation to be able to make that leap of faith to move forward. Because if you don't do that, you will never grow as a business person, as a human, as a person, as your own.
As a parent.
As a parent. This, and again, this reflects on every aspect of life. You have to push yourself out of your comfort zone. If you do not, you will stay stable at the same line. And for some people, that's okay. But most people watching this video, and most people on YouTube, and most people
that
have
made
are,
it this far on this
are,
video.
Exactly,
this video.
That have made it this far, and that's willing to watch these videos of growth.
Yeah.
You want to better yourself. You want to become greater and bigger and better than what you're doing right now. So push yourself out of your comfort zone. Push yourself mentally out of that. What are you pointing at?
No, because I really like what you said. Sorry, I didn't want to cut you off.
No, it's okay. Go.
I really like what you said about building your motorcycle. I think that's really like how we build our own minds. At the end of the day, no matter where you come from, no matter you come from a rich family, a poor family, from parents that are together or split, your mind is a product of your everything. Like your upbringing, your surrounding, your five closest friends. You know, you're friends with five losers, you're going to be the sixth. Your friend with five millionaires, you're going to be the sixth.
Mm-hmm.
And I think if you build your own confidence, if you're the one who gives yourself the confidence, you're the one
that motivates yourself.
You're your motivator. You're the one who built your confidence. You're the one who built your whole mental blocks by yourself. Okay?
Jeez. You're pumping me up.
Yeah, so if you build all those blocks in your head, the same as he built the motorcycle. When there's something wrong, you will be able to know what it is.
Self-motivation, self-creation, self-better yourself. It's all about finding out how to get comfortable within.
Within.
Know how to control yourself.
Exactly. Because if you think about it, everything in our lives, we created. We created our businesses. We created our channel. We created our family. And we create our happiness. And so because we create all those things, if we wake up some mornings and we're not happy, we're able to help each other because we built that. So if you rely on other people for your confidence, or you rely on them, you don't think you're pretty, but you rely on somebody else to
tell you
to tell you you're pretty. Well, what happens when those people disappear, or when those people become too busy, or when those people become assholes and don't tell you you're pretty? What happens? You're left with nothing.
And you gotta look at yourself every single day and tell yourself you're great.
You are.
Forget about everybody else around you. Look at yourself and control yourself.
Yes.
That's the key.
Yes, because if you tell a kid they're great every day, they're going to grow up thinking they're great. And that's
without being great.
Exactly. Even if they're not, they're going to think they are. Mm-hmm. And it's just really good to be self-aware. And there's just so many people in my life that have made me the person that I am today. Like, the person that always told me I was great is a different person than the person that taught me discipline.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, I took that from everybody. And I took what I needed, and I shaped myself as a person. And then same thing as you. And I think that unless you are your motivation, and unless you do it for yourself, and it sounds tacky because I've heard this before, but unless you decide for yourself to do something, you will never achieve it.
Never.
If you want to quit smoking for somebody else, you'll never achieve it. If you want to have a diploma, like I wanted a bachelor's in finance, that was my goal. If I would have done that for somebody else, I would have never pulled through.
Mm-hmm.
And so the goal here is to do it for yourself. It's not selfish to take time for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
It's not selfish to build yourself up. And guess what? If you mess up, or if you don't look as great that day, it's okay to be honest. You don't have to be fake positive and think that, you know, you gained 45 pounds. But it's okay because you have to be honest with yourself. Do
100%.
You feel good? Do you feel like you look good?
And
I want
to touch on something too.
Go.
And a huge mistake that anybody could do to themselves is falsify, motivate themselves. Like
I call that toxic positivity.
Toxic positivity. That's like, what I wanted to say.
You're running fast.
You're running fast, but you're not going nowhere.
Exactly. So you think you're like, yeah, we're doing good. We're working hard. Yeah.
But realistically, like, you look back and you're like, wait, I'm in the same footsteps that I was.
And to not do that, it's very simple. You need to be aligned. You need to be aligned in terms of your spending, your saving, your health.
And
we have never been at our potential since we have not been on the same journey of health.
And realizing when you're making mistakes.
Yes, catching yourself before you slip.
Look, if there's one thing that we can say that we're masters of, is we're masters of being able to catch our mistakes like this.
Yeah.
We're able to make, you know, a step on something on the same day and be able to step back and be like, wait a second.
We made a mistake.
This doesn't make no sense. Like, how about we should, like, I always call it like an audible, like almost like football. Like, we got to pull an audible and like fix it.
You say that all the time.
Instantly.
And guys,
we don't let things drag on longer than a day or a half a day or a quarter of a day. And if you guys are long-term viewers, you guys know that me and Sam speak at night before we go to bed. Sam and I like talk before we go to bed. And we touch base on like different aspects of our life. And we say like, hey, we're doing this, you know, should we change and like maybe like touch it like on a different like, you know, aspect of like, you know, be able to like improve a certain way of doing things or whatever.
And don't think these are small mistakes. Like
are huge mistakes.
Like,
trust me.
I have made a mistake before and I'm going to touch this because like we created our own life. So when we make mistakes, we actually pay the price. Okay. There's nobody else that pays the price, but us. And we don't talk about them because nobody gives it like a crap. Nobody cares if you lose, but I waited to answer a client one day because I was being lazy. I was not disciplined and I was pushing off a client to answer him because I knew that he wanted the job. And so instead of answering him right away, I pushed that off, I think 3 or 4 days. And that was entirely my fault. And we lost a $15,000 job because of that. And, you know, I know. And, you know, he's amazing. Like, he didn't even have a grudge. Like, I had a grudge against myself. And I should have a grudge against myself. Nobody should say, oh, but, you know, you didn't mean to. No. It's your fault. Yes, you did put it off. You lost. And guess what? We lost $15,000. Like, that's a lot of money, guys.
Yeah.
How could I do that? And that's just because I was not disciplined. I was not in the right, like, mindset. I was just not motivated. I was feeling depressed. And it's so stupid. It's stupid. But it happens.
And for example, like when that happened, what I did as a partner. So like if there's a couple watching this and you guys want to get an idea of like how we work.
Yeah.
So I came home. She told me this story. And I told her, yes, inside. I was like, man, you know, we just lost a $15,000 job.
Yeah.
But I told myself like, how should I react to this situation to like, you know, bring light to this situation? So I decided to take steps and basically tell her, hey, you know what? Don't worry about it. It's going to be okay. We lost a job. There's going to be another job that's going to come in. We'll work a little bit harder. But let that be a lesson that you should respect every job like it's your last job or your first job. And that comes down to like even money. You have to respect your dollars like it's your first dollar and your last dollar. 100%.
You respect $20 the same as you respect $30,000. And it's not because you're making, you know, you made $10,000 one week that you should be like, ha, I made it. Because if you do that, you will fall next week.
100%.
It's called hubris. It's a Greek term. And anybody that has read Greek mythology knows this. Hubris is when you think everything is going to be fine because everything is great. And you kind of like, you're being cocky. That always, and Evan has told me every time he's been cocky in his life, it has fallen flat in his face. And guess what?
First.
Me too. So stay humble and
stay tuned to like real videos that we're going to produce for you guys.
Yeah.
Explaining our downfalls, our mistakes. We have stories to tell you guys that you guys will be able to piece all the puzzles together.
Yeah.
And be able to say like, wow, this is like the mistakes that they've got. Like we have stories
like
that will make you guys.
Yeah.
like literally wait. Say like how sorry to like
no I'm just like, I want to give guys, little glimpses like
yeah make you guys literally realize you were like yeah. How did these two
come out of that
pull themselves out of that situation and be in this position where they're at. All right, so to finish off this video, guys, we're going to give you guys a little tip and trick like we just did before, but now this is going to be an extra bonus for the people that made it this far. When you look at a situation, most people look at two doors, okay? You look at door one and door two.
Two options.
Okay? You say, do you tell yourself, I could go through this door and it'll give me this, or I go through that door and it'll give me that. But guess what? You create a third door. That's what champs and that's what winners do, okay? You make your own destiny.
Make
you don't
your own
have
door.
To choose those two doors. You break down a wall and you create a third door, okay? And you pave your way through that third door. Don't let anybody else tell you that you have to make choices, because the choice that you make comes within yourself. You make your own choice and you make your own road. So with that being said, it was a little bit hard,
yeah,
but
we love you
it's
guys.
The reality. So we love you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this motivational video. I hope you guys got some inspiration out of this video, because we love talking about this. Baby, anything else?
No, we love you guys. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and we'll catch you guys on Sunday with a family vlog and also a vlog of how I got this big bump on my face. So see you guys on Sunday, and we love you.